Hey Design Nation, in this session, I'm going to teach you the difference between tools, plugins, and extensions in Sketchup. And then I'm going to teach you how to find some and how to install them once you do. I'm just going to start off this by saying that the difference between tools, plugins, and extensions is pretty slight. And in Sketchup 2014, the lines start to get pretty blurred. I'll go into that a little bit later, but for now I'm just going to describe how those three are typically defined. Okay, so tools are anything that is built into SketchUp. So if I was to say grab the rectangle tool, you would grab this, and not any sort of plugin. A plugin is typically something that you add into SketchUp. It's an added feature that doesn't come with the vanilla version. So I'm going to teach you how to find and install those. And then the other thing is extensions, which are usually sort of robust plugins. They're not developed by SketchUp. They're developed by third parties, just like plugins. And a lot of times they have more robust features like user interfaces. They can do a little bit more. And they just look nicer and usually work better. So since this is a vanilla version of SketchUp, I don't have any extensions or plugins installed. So it's going to be a good sort of learning experience if you've never installed any plugins or extensions. So since SketchUp 2013, they added the extension warehouse, so installing extensions has become super easy. So if you go to Window and scroll down to Extension Warehouse, it'll pop out this Extension Warehouse window. In here, there are different ways to navigate through the extensions, so you can choose your industry or your category. So I might start with architecture, since that's the field that I'm in, and maybe I'm looking for drawing. Over here it'll tell you the price, if there is a price. But for this one it's free, so you just click on it. And the easy way to do this is just hit install. You can see that it didn't actually do anything, and that's because I'm not signed in. So it might be frustrating at first if you keep clicking this and it doesn't do anything. So all you have to do is sign in with your account, and then you'll be good to go. So now that I'm signed into my account, when I hit install, you'll see that it pops up a message and it says, do you trust the author? And I'm going to say yes. And it's going to go through and it's going to install. And now you can see that I have a toolbar. So now I'm going to show you sort of the manual way to install extensions, and I'll talk about how to uninstall them if you get tired of the ones that you need. A really good website to go to if you're looking for plugins or extensions is Ruby Library Depot. There's also Smustard. It's also a very good website to go to. And you just click home or products, and you can search through. Some of them are free and some of them are paid. For this, I have already discovered a couple that I've discovered an extension and a plugin, so I'm just going to use this for now. But essentially, you just hit download. It'll download it to your file, and then I'll take it from there how you install. Okay, so I've downloaded my two files, and they're in my downloads folder. This one has the extension RBZ at the end, and this one just says RB. The one with the Z is an extension, and the one with the B is a plugin. The first thing you need to do is to go to your C drive and your program files, and you need to find your SketchUp folder. So that's essentially what I'm doing. SketchUp, the latest version that you want to install your plugin on. I'm using 14. And this is where the discrepancy comes in that I was talking about earlier. So in previous versions of SketchUp, there was a plugins folder. Now there's this folder called tools, which is essentially the same thing. So you want to drop your plugin over here. You can see there are other plugins in there now. Just hit continue. And I'm going to drop this in there as well. You'll need to exit out of your current version of SketchUp if you have it open, and then restart it. I installed Weld, so you can see in plugins there's this new tab that wasn't there before. Weld is in there. Sometimes the plugins won't show up there, depending on the plugin. And like if you select these lines, you'll be able to right click and there might be an option in here. That's pretty often, but you should be able to look at some README files for your plugin, and the author should describe how to use their plugin. So we have this plugin installed, but now we don't have the other extension. So the manual way to do that is go to Window, Preferences, and you'll see here there's this extensions. To install the extension, you go down here, Install Extensions, and then you have to find where we saved that previous file. So if I go back to my C drive, my SketchUp folder, 2014, I put it in Tools. You'll see that this file is showing up, and the other .rb files are not, because they aren't extensions. So I'm going to hit Open. It's going to put me through that same process that it did before, when I installed through the extension warehouse. You can see that it is complete. If at any point you want to turn any plugins off, you just come in here and you uncheck them. So if I didn't want my 101 bit tools, I would just come in here and turn that off, and then you have to restart SketchUp for it not to show up. But I'm going to hit OK, and you can see I have my tree extension in here. I've never used this before, but there you go. If you found this information helpful, and you know anyone who is having an issue installing plugins or extensions, please forward this video along to them. And if you like this video and want to be notified of more just like it, go to our YouTube channel and subscribe. Our YouTube content comes out a few days before our post on our website, designerhacks.com, so you can get an exclusive preview of the newest video tutorials that we're putting out. I hope you guys have a good one, and as always, happy hacking.
If you hit show terrain, it's going to add contours to the site, which is really helpful for if you're modeling. It's rough, this isn't as accurate as a survey would be, but it gives you a decent quick overview of sort of what the site contours look like.